Well, good morning. Sunrise. About that time. I was thinking as a pastor, man, I have had some very interesting sunrise services. I got to tell you one funny real quick while we're waiting for other people to come. We were pastoring together in Arkansas, in a very rural town called London, Arkansas. And I've got many of you this morning that are still part of that congregation, that are part of this congregation now. And that year, we decided to have a water baptismal service. And me and another community church, we decided, hey, let's have a water baptismal service sunrise Sunday morning. And so my friend got in the water. He baptized first. Everything went great. I got in the water to start baptizing those in my congregation. And everybody started yelling at me. I mean, everybody started hollering and
waving,
shouting and waving.
Screaming.
And I thought was having one of the greatest Pentecostal services we'd ever had, and I'd not even preached yet. But what they were trying to tell me is behind me there were snakes. There literally were water moccasins coming towards us. We had stirred them. And I will tell you, for the very first time in my life, I knew what it was to feel like walking on water. We got out of there so fast. And by the way,
it looked like it too.
The last one that had to be baptized was baptized in about 8 inches of water. But we did it. And so, you know, even today, this morning, we were wanting to be at another location. And we got there, was getting ready, and realized that part of the equipment that we needed the most, matter of fact, my camera
was right here.
So we had to run, we had to drive back here very quick. So that's why we're a little late today. We're so glad that you've joined us this morning.
A couple other things that have happened. We've had some crazy Easters. Most of the time, working up to Easter, I would spend the last week or two sewing and making matching dresses for the girls. And of course, I remember the Easter Sunday morning when it was catastrophic that all of a sudden Becky informed me that she didn't want to wear a dress that looked like mama and sister anymore. And it was Easter Sunday morning. So that was just kind of crazy right there. And then, I remember a very important Easter Sunday morning that happened. We actually had a huge citywide Easter egg hunt on Easter Sunday afternoon. And right in the middle of that Easter egg hunt, I went into premature labor with Shelby. So that was an interesting Easter. And I spent that whole next week in the hospital trying to get labor stopped, which we did. But you know, so we have fond memories of Easter, funny things that happened. But you know, there's an Easter in particular that stands out to me that probably encapsulates what Easter is.
Yes.
We were in our first church, and we had had a lot of difficult situations that had come up. Precious, precious people. But there were difficult situations, and we were green behind the ears and didn't really know what we were doing. And those precious people supported us. But, oh, love the Lord. Those people loved the Lord, and they were all about seeing their community one to Jesus. And we had a young couple that lived not too far from the church, and they had been curious about what was going on at the church, and they had children the same age as our kids, and so we kind of struck up a friendship there. And I remember that we invited them to church, and it was a couple of weeks before Easter that they came, and I remember very vividly the front of that church. It was a little country church, and there was an altar on one side where the women prayed and an altar on the other side where the men prayed. And I never will forget that Sunday morning. Their children were in, all our kids were in children's church. And I remember the invitation was given that Sunday morning, and I remember watching that couple. I remember she walked down to the ladies' side, and he walked down to the men's side, and they both gave their heart to Jesus.
Yes.
And it was such an amazing, amazing, amazing thing that Sunday. And you thought, well, how can you top that? Well, you know, this young woman particularly fell head over heels in love with Jesus Christ when she began to realize what he had actually done for her. And I remember standing on the ball field talking to her, and I was telling her about Easter Sunday that was coming and Resurrection Day, and how we were going to celebrate that Jesus had conquered death, hell, and the grave, and that he didn't stay in the tomb, and that he came out again. And I remember standing there on that ball field and watching her tears pour down her face. And I remember the words that came out of her mouth, and she said, "Do you mean we get a whole day that the nation sets aside to celebrate what Jesus did?"
Yes, yes, yes.
And I said, "Yes, sweetheart, that's about right. That's about right." And I remember that Easter Sunday morning, they come walking in with their family. And, you know, they didn't have a whole lot, and they weren't dressed really fancy, but the smiles that they wore was unbelievable. And I remember as soon as that first chord on the piano was struck, her hands were in the air, and she was praising Jesus. And I was thinking about that this morning, and it just came back, and I thought, what a glorious day. You know, it's cloudy outside. We can't even see the sun coming up this morning because of the clouds, and they're telling us we're going to have severe weather today, and we're still under stay-at-home orders from the government and COVID-19 running rampant. But you know what? Jesus Christ is still on the throne, and we are still going to worship Him. He's alive today. Amen. There is nothing that has ever come our way that He couldn't handle, and there's nothing that ever will come our way that He can't handle. And I'm so thankful this morning that we can celebrate Resurrection Sunday right here and start our day off with you guys, our church family. We just love you so much. And those of you that are watching from around the community and in different states and wherever you're watching from this morning, we just welcome you and are just so thankful that you are here with us today. And we're going to, my husband's going to bring the word that the Lord's laid upon his heart. And we're going to end with a song this morning. And then we're going to be right back at 9:45 for Sunday school. And then we're going to be right back at 11 o'clock for worship this morning. And you know what? You've got nowhere else to be. What a glorious place to be together with the Lord on Resurrection Sunday.
Amen. Amen. My wife and I were talking. We have lived in this community a little over 21 years this year. 22 in August. And we have been through so much in this county. With you, we went through so many different things. We went through Y2K. We went through Katrina. We've gone through tornadoes. But what I have loved is watching the local pastors in our, not only our county, but surrounding counties and communities, just rally for the moment and Christ be lifted up. I literally had somebody tell me the other day that is not really serving the Lord much. They said to me, "I have no excuse not being in church because I can get church absolutely anytime I turn Facebook on, anytime I go to YouTube." And I realized that my relationship with God is not where it needed to be. And so I've got more church now than I've ever had in my life. And when I got off the phone with that person, I thought, God, you're doing greater things than we could ever imagine.
You know, I've watched through the years, sweetheart, you mentioned those different things, Y2K and Katrina. And, you know, I never will forget between Hurricane Ivan and Hurricane Katrina, we had a hurricane wreck our lives, and it was leukemia.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes when I look at my husband and I look at how well he's doing, sometimes I forget that he has leukemia and that he takes a little pill every day, chemo, every single day. But God has weathered those storms with us, and you have weathered those storms with us. And it is just proof that Jesus Christ brings those things that seem dead back to life, you know?
Yes.
And the destruction that was Katrina, and we've watched Him bring families back to life, and the destruction that was your leukemia, you know, we've stood on promises and the prophetic word that was given by Edgar and Janora Reed when we come home from the hospital, that this is not unto death.
Right.
And we have stood on that for these almost 16 years. And Jesus specializes in bringing that which was dead back to life.
He does. God's so good to us.
Amen.
Have your Bibles with you. Wow. There's just so many different things that we could go to the Lord about. But If you would go with me to the book of Luke, chapter 24. And I want to read a lot of verses and then give some explanation to it. And let's set the scene. Our Savior is crucified. He has talked about that he was going to rise again, but the word resurrection really had not registered yet. They're huddled quietly in a room. There has been total chaos in their life. Their life has been turned upside down. All hope is lost. Peace is not there, but there's an obligation of we must complete the process of burial. We must complete it. And they knew that that day they would have the right to go back and complete that process. So now let's read it together. In the book of Luke, chapter 24, upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came into the sepulcher bringing the spices which they had prepared and certain others with them. They found the stone rolled away from the sepulcher. They entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. It came to pass as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said unto them, why seek ye the living among the dead?
Amen.
He is not here, but he is risen. Remember how he spake unto you when he say yet in Galilee, saying the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, be crucified, and the third day rise again. Can I tell you, we all have a hearing disorder. Sometimes we really don't hear what the Spirit of God is trying to say to us. And the Holy Spirit was already directing them through the very words of Christ. He had been saying it many times to them, but they were hard-headed, just like you and I. And they remembered those words all at once. It's like an aha moment. It's a moment that everything comes back to life. And can I say this? I think for the very first time in their life, even the Old Testament scriptures that they had memorized as a child woke up. I think the scriptures in Isaiah, for the very first time, really the realization of what they were saying, what he was saying, I believe that they sat there and it just like light, spiritual light bulbs just went off.
Yes.
Because he truly was who he said he was.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they returned, verse 9, and they returned from the sepulcher and told all those things unto the 11 and to all the rest. And it was Mary Magdalene and Janone and Mary the mother of James and the other women that were with them which told those things unto the apostles. And their words seemed to them as idle tales, and they believed them not.
Yes.
I think there's a lot of times in God's word that we read it, but we don't believe it. It looks like an idle fable. When we say that the sun's coming up in the morning and we're living in the time that we're living in right now, it's kind of like, oh, yeah, really? Or there's a new hope. Oh, really? Or it's going to be a blessed day. Or his mercies are new every day. See, all at once, scriptures just start flooding back into your heart of what God is saying. It's not idle words. It's not fables. It's spirit-breathed words for you and I to live by. We are physical beings with the spirit of the resurrection Savior living with inside of us this morning.
Amen.
We have hope.
Amen.
And we have peace.
Yes.
So let's read a little
praise
further.
God.
And the words which seemed to them as idle tales, and they believed them not. And there arose Peter and ran into the sepulcher, stooping down and beheld the linen cloths and laid by themselves and departed, wondering in himself at that which was come to pass. And you're going to find different stories as he is going to be seen by infallible witnesses. And can I say to you this morning that you have infallible witnesses all around you of the goodness of God. You have people that maybe are self-quarantined or maybe that are working on the front lines of things that are going on today, but you have infallible witnesses of the blessed
yes.
hope of a risen Savior.
Yes.
And I want you to start looking for life.
Yes.
And quit counting death.
Amen.
Death has been conquered.
Amen. Praise
the grave has been conquered.
Yes.
And we need to look to life. We need to look to light.
Yes.
We need to know who we are
yes.
in Christ Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So may God bless you this morning as my wife sings a song for you.
One of my favorites, Sister Tony, requested this a couple weeks back, and I just pray that this blesses you this morning. Well, we're going to have another technical difficulty. It's okay. The sun, where to stand in the morning, and who told the ocean you can only come this far, and who showed the moon where to hide till evening, whose words alone can catch a falling star. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. All of creation testifies. This life within me cries, I know my Redeemer, He lives. Yes, the very same God that spins things in orbit, runs to the weary, the worn and the weak, and those same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken, they conquer death to bring me victory. This life within me cries, I know my Redeemer, He lives to take away my shame, and He payment for my sin was the precious life He gave, but now He's alive and there's an empty grave. Now I know my Redeemer lives. Testify this life within me cry, I know my Redeemer.
Hallelujah.
I know.
Yes, Lord.
I know my Redeemer lives.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, I know. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow.
Hallelujah.
He lives. I spoke with him this morning. He lives.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
We are just looking forward to today. I'm out of the scene, out of the picture, but may God richly bless you and be with you and walk with you today. We challenge you. Get up, dress up.
Amen.
Today's the Lord's day. Give Him your best today. Turn the televisions off. Have family time. Cherished memories.
Amen.
May God richly bless.
We'll see you at 9:45 for Sunday school, 11 o'clock for worship. God bless you.